Hi there, Serdar Yegulalp here. In this episode of Dev with Serdar, I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to use .env files with Go projects. Ruby and Python users, to name two other languages, can set environment variables for a given app by declaring them in a file and then by reading that file's settings into their program. Go doesn't have a native standard library way to do this, but there is a third-party option, go.env. In fact, it's a port of the Ruby implementation of the concept. Here is a simple example of this at work. I have a project with a .env file in its root, which contains a single value, API key. The format of the file is usually just a list of key value pairs separated by line breaks, nothing's fancy. In the program itself, I only need to do a couple of things. One is to import the go.env package. Next, we execute go.env load, which reads in the .env file and adds its values to the local environment. Then we can access these environment values the way we usually do in Go, by way of the os.getenv method. So if we run this code, you'll see that the program prints out the API key we loaded in from the environment. We can then do whatever we want with this value. We can also read in other values from the environment later on if we need to, as anything loaded in from .env persists over the lifetime of the program. Another thing we can do is load a file by name if we need to. For instance, if we have multiple .env files that we want to switch between programmatically for different scenarios. In this case, I have an environment file that isn't named .env. All I have to do is pass that file name to .load. So if we run this code, you'll see that it loads environment data from a completely different file. It's just that .env is the typical default, and so that's what it looks for first. Another convenience that go.env gives you is automatic import. If we rewrite our code a little bit, like this, we can change our import of the package to use the autoload package in go.env. And then we don't need to explicitly read in the .env file, it'll just read it in automatically on package import. So if we run this version of the code, you can see we're going to get our environment variables automatically with no intervention on our part. However, there's one little downside to doing things this way. If we remove or rename the .env file, the import will fail silently, and instead of having a value in our environment, we'll just have nothing. So if you want to explicitly trap errors on import with .env, if you want to make sure there's actually a file there, you will want to do this manually. So to sum up, you can use .env files in your Go projects with the third-party go.env package. Once .env files are loaded, the values persist for the lifetime of the application. And you can automatically load a .env file or specify one manually, depending on how granular you want your error behavior to be. So that's it for this video. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And if you want more Dev with Serdar, be sure to follow me on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.